check, 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 check.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
is risen. Woo! Here we go.
Did you feel the mountains tremble? Did you hear the oceans roar? When the people rose to sing of Jesus Christ the risen one. Did you feel the people tremble? Did you hear the singers roar? When the lost began to sing of Jesus Christ the saving one. And we could see that God just moving a mighty river through the nations, and young and old will turn to Jesus. Fling wide you heavenly gates, prepare the way of the join in one song, and all the streams flow as one river to wash away our brokenness. And we can see that God you're moving a mighty river through the nations, and young and old will turn to Jesus.
Yes.
Fling wide
love.
Some super test coffee. So glad that you're here. Happy Easter. We're so glad to share this good news. He is risen. He is risen indeed. I'm so glad you're here to celebrate with us. I'm Pastor Heather Hayward. For those that don't know, we're glad that you're here. I'm so thankful to everybody who makes this day possible, but not the least of which is that God makes it possible. So I hope you hear some really good news for your soul today. So we're so glad you're here. We do also have a connection on Facebook, so we always kind of say hello to our Facebook family. Good morning, glad you're here. Post those prayers and peace and share that with us. Well, we're so glad to have you here in worship as we celebrate. Let's continue to worship and sing.
Blessed be your name, the found in the desert place, who I walk through the wilderness. Blessed be your name. Every blessing you pour out, I'll turn back to praise. When the darkness closes in, Lord, still I will say, blessed be the name of the Lord, blessed be your name. Blessed be the name of the Lord, blessed be your glorious name. Blessed be your name when the sun's shining down on me, when the world's all as it should be. Blessed be your name.
blessed be your name. On the road marked with suffering, still paid in the offering, blessed be your name.
Every blessing you pour out, I'll turn back to praise. When the darkness closes in, Lord, still I will say, blessed be the name of the Lord, blessed be your name.
Bless God's name for the great news we have today. You can be seated, and I invite all kids up. Miss Jessica has some fun things to share with you. Come on up. Come on up. So many.
Oh. Good morning. What are we celebrating at church this morning?
Easter.
What happens on Easter besides the goodies we woke up to? Lars.
No.
What happens? Yeah, Jesus is risen. Do you want to help me demonstrate to the congregation how the disciples felt that morning? You think that'd be pretty fun? Okay, let's all line up, and you can face our friends. And I'm going to read the story and then whisper an action you should be doing, okay? Early on Sunday morning, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene went to the tomb where Jesus had been buried.
Okay, walk in place.
Keep walking. She found that the stone was rolled away from the entrance, and she ran.
Now run in place.
And found Simon Peter and
keep running.
Found Simon Peter and another disciple, John. She told them,
cup your hands around your mouth like this.
They have put the Lord's body out of the tomb, and I don't know where they've put him.
Oh.
Peter and John started out for the tomb.
Okay, run again.
They were both running, but John outran Peter and reached the tomb first. He stooped and looked in and saw the linen wrappings lying there, but he didn't go in. Okay, bend down like you're looking in the tomb. Then Simon Peter arrived and went inside. He noticed the cloth that... Keep bending. He noticed that the cloth that covered Jesus' head was folded up and lying apart from the other wrappings. Then John saw and believed. Okay, now put your hand over your heart. For until then, they still hadn't understood the scriptures that said Jesus must rise from the dead. And then they went home. You can run again. Mary stayed behind weeping. Pretend to cry. Cry. Oh. As she knelt down and looked inside the tomb, she saw two angels dressed in white. Kneel. They asked her why she was crying, and she told them she didn't know where they had taken Jesus. Then Mary turned and saw a man standing behind her. It was Jesus, but Mary did not recognize him. Yep, surprise face. She thought he was the gardener. Then Jesus called her by name, and when she heard his voice, she recognized him. Still surprised. After she saw that it was Jesus, she went to the disciples and said to them, I've seen Jesus. He's alive. Okay, now jump up and down in excitement. He's alive. Good job. That was okay. You can have a seat again. Isn't that the best news to share? Yeah. Yes, because we thought Jesus was dead on Friday, and now he's risen, and now he's alive. Yes, he's risen. So you'll notice that today we say, he is risen, and then usually you respond, he is risen indeed. Should we practice? Show the adults how loud we can do it. He is risen.
He is risen indeed.
Good job. All right. So now, so today and the rest of the week and the rest of the month, let's keep sharing with all the people that Jesus has risen.
He is risen.
All right, let's pray. You can repeat after me. Oh, dear God, on this glorious Easter morning, we rejoice in the resurrection of your Son, Jesus.
We rejoice in the resurrection of your Son, Jesus.
Thank you for the hope.
Thank you for the hope.
And the new life that Easter brings.
And the new life that Easter brings.
In Jesus' name we pray.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Thanks for coming up, you guys. Thank you so much for acting out this great news that we have today. I think everybody loves getting good news, right? Especially when we look at the actual news. That doesn't always seem so good. So to hear, congratulations, you got the job. Or congratulations, you're pregnant, or, you know, you got that promotion, or the oven doesn't need to be fixed this time, or the cancer is gone. Some news is better than others, right? The cancer is gone is always going to surpass the fact that the oven doesn't need to be fixed. We have the best news that surpasses all other good news today. That because Jesus is alive, we have new life. That because Jesus is no longer dead, we don't need to fear death for ourselves or for those around us. He has literally gone to hell and back for you and for me. So today we have some of the best news. He lives so that death no longer claims us. He lives, and so now nothing, I mean nothing, stands between you and the love that God has for you. Nothing stands between you. He lives so that you can now live here and now and eternally with him forever. And that changes everything. Because he is risen, we can shout this good news as the kids did. He is risen. He is risen indeed. He is risen. He is risen indeed. That is such amazing news. It's over the top. Russ wants to do it one more time. He is risen.
He is risen.
There we go. Do you feel complete now? Yes, you feel complete. Three times is the holy number, so I should have done three times. You're right. You're right. So, you know, I realized something this year that I have only ever preached from John's gospel on Easter. And as I read that gospel again, you know, the kids talked about it, that Mary Magdalene comes, she sees Jesus, he calls her by name. I love that story. But we've been dwelling in the Gospel of Mark this year. And so I went to read Mark's version of Easter morning. And I have to tell you, it really resonated with me this year. I'll warn you, it is very different from John. So let's hear what Mark has to say. This is Mark chapter 16. When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James and Salome, brought spices so that they might go and anoint him. Very early on the first day of the week, when the sun had risen, they went to the tomb. They'd been saying to one another, "Who will roll away the stone for us from the entrance of the tomb?" But when they looked up, they saw that the stone, which was very large, had already been rolled back. And they entered the tomb. They saw a young man dressed in white robe sitting on the right side, and they were alarmed. But he said to them, "Do not be afraid, for you are looking for Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified. He has been raised. He is not here. Look, there's the place where they laid him. But go tell his disciples and Peter that he is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him, just as he told you." So they went out and fled from the tomb, for terror and amazement had seized them. And they said nothing to anyone, for they were afraid. The Gospel of the Lord. Thanks be to God. That's it. Period. Jesus doesn't show up. They don't have that moment of recognition. They left silent. They said nothing to anyone, for they were afraid. No recognition on their faces. No appearance of Jesus. No happy, happy plastic Easter joy. In this gospel, right? That felt real to me this year. That felt like what actually happened. Instead of this automatic, you know, the lights go up and we sing hallelujah, it took time for this good news to soak in. I think sometimes that's how good news works. I think for me, every time I hear this good news, every time I remember God's grace, it soaks in just a little deeper that this good news is actually for me. I don't get to just preach it. It's for me, too, that God is alive for me. I think sometimes good news is like that. It takes a while for it to soak in. We've known that this is good news for 2,000 years, right? It takes time for this good news to soak in. So I hope today it soaks in a little bit more. It may feel like those women leave the tomb and nothing has changed, but there's actually some evidence here that something is different. And only if you know ancient Greek would you really be able to tell. So anybody know ancient Greek? Oh, good. Okay, so I can help you. So that last sentence has some words that if we know them in Greek, I think actually show us what has changed. The word that's translated terror or fear, they're seized with terror, is phobos, where we get phobia, right? But that word actually means trembling in awe. Like not you've watched a horror movie or the news and you're fearful, right? It is trembling in awe that God would do something so amazing. They're trembling because they know God has been there. And then that word that is translated amazement, they're filled with amazement, is ekstasia, where we get ecstasy, which literally means they are standing in a different place. They were standing here, now they stand here. Something did change. This filled with fear and amazement isn't just a paralyzing thing. They know something has changed. Because the tomb is empty, they stand in a different place. Because of this good news, you stand in a different place. All of creation stands in a different place because of the news of this morning. Sometimes I think it feels like our life is static, like nothing changes, like there's nothing new under the sun. We watch the news and it's the same thing over and over again. We feel that in our own lives of like day in, day out, what is changed about my life because of Jesus? But I hope that these words can help you think about how you stand in a different place because of the good news of this morning. I wonder how often we feel like these women. Like we know something has changed, but it hasn't completely soaked in yet. Maybe you feel like you're still in Friday, or even that Saturday waiting. But Sunday changes everything. That the news of this day changes everything. Maybe things in your life right now feel chaotic and fearful. But today changes everything. Because the tomb is empty, everything has changed.
Sunday changes everything. The stone has been rolled away. The women have received a message. The soldiers have retreated in fear. The disciples have run to the tomb. Sunday changes everything. Doubts are put in their place. Miracles are performed. The disciples eat breakfast made by the king. Jesus is on the loose. And because Jesus is on the loose, death is conquered. Funeral clothes are cast aside. Light shines forth from the tomb. Hope crushes fear. Faith conquers doubt. Belief moves mountains. Relationship consumes religion. God's love wins. Jesus changes everything. Because Jesus is on the loose, your tears are wiped away. Your sin is washed away. Your life will never be the same. Jesus changes everything. And because Jesus changes everything, every knee shall bow, every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Jesus changes everything.
Today changes everything. Power now looks like love and service and sacrifice. That fear and anxiety that can grip us now have to loosen their hold. Those who have sat at the graves of their loved ones no longer need to be sad, because death is conquered. Death is no more, because today changes everything. I want you to dwell in this good news. We aren't just called to proclaim it, we're called to live it. Live out this fact that because the tomb is empty, your life is different. You are free. Death no longer holds you. This day can change all other days. There's another piece of good news that I read in this story that I'm not sure I had really taken a hold of before. In 20-some years of preaching Easter, I don't know how much I had thought about the stone. Friday night, the curtain is ripped from top to bottom that separates the Holy of Holies from everyone else. But today, the final barrier is moved. That stone being rolled away, you are no longer separated from anything that would have kept you from God. Nothing separates you from the love of God in Christ Jesus. Because that stone is rolled away, you literally are standing in a different place because God has freed you. That stone, everything that separated you, no longer stands in the way because that stone has been rolled away. Today, I want you to take a reminder of that with you. There are baskets of stones at each door as you leave today. I want you to take one. Take one, put it somewhere where you will see it regularly so that you can remember that because of this day, nothing stands between you and your God. Nothing stands between you and the sense that death no longer wins. Nothing stands between you and that fear and anxiety that can hold us back. God releases all of it as that stone is rolled away. So I hope you will take one of these with you today. Or any time you see a stone, be reminded that Jesus is on the loose. That because of that, you are free. Death no longer holds you. Fear and anxiety no longer holds you. You are free because He is risen. He is risen indeed. He is risen. He is risen indeed. He is risen. He is risen indeed. Alleluia. Let's pray. God, thank you so much for this amazing news, this news that surpasses all other news. That you are on the loose in the world and in our hearts. Lord, we are so thankful. We can't even describe our thankfulness. So, Lord, for those ways that fear and anxiety and anger and grief can hold us captive, Lord, let us be reminded today that because that stone is rolled away, you have rolled away those things that can hold us bound. You've freed us indeed. In your holy and precious name we pray. Amen. Let's stand as we're able and join in singing.
You called me from the grave by name. You called me out of all my shame. I see the old has passed away. The new has come. Now I have resurrection power. Living on the inside, Jesus, you have given us freedom. No longer I'm dressed in your royalty. Your Holy Spirit lives in me. I see my past has been
us this amazing freedom. There's something else that we share as a community because of God's gift, and we really need to carry it out into the world, and that is the measure of God's peace. So we share that with one another, not as like a little like social break in the middle of worship, which it kind of is that, but it also is a way to expand God's peace in the world. So the peace of the Lord be with you always. Thank you. Won't you share that with one another? Hugs, kisses, high fives, peace signs, however you want to do it.
Thank you.
awesome. Thank you so much. Thank you for sharing that Easter peace with one another. That's awesome. I had a couple people hand me some connection cards, and that's a great reminder. Please do fill these out. If you're able, or if you're new, if you're visiting, we'd love to connect with you. So these are in the chair in front of you. If you'd like to fill that out, there are silver bowls by each door that you can fill those out. There's also a place on the back for prayer requests. If you would like to share a prayer with me, our prayer team, or the congregation, there's a way that you can do that on there as well. So thank you. I'm so glad you're here. Our regular Sunday services are at 8 a.m. and 9:45 a.m. So we hope you'll, if this is your first time here, we want to welcome you and invite you to come and join us next Sunday as well. So we hope you're here. And again, I said at the beginning, like this takes a village to make this whole week happen. So thank you to all the ways that people have made this happen. For all the parts of being in worship, of decorating, of the Easter egg hunt yesterday. I mean, there's just so many ways that this week is many hands making light work. So thank you for that. I wanted to point out on this little sheet that's out on the tables, if you didn't already grab one, please do grab one on the way out. It has all the information about our children and youth ministries, what we do every Sunday, but also what we're planning for our summer. So I hope you'll grab one of those and give Jessica a call if you have questions, or send her an email as well. So a few things we have coming up. We love that God has given us this amazing space, that we are to care for it. That's our call as God's stewards. And so we want to spruce up our land. So if you're able to come for a spring cleanup day, it's a wonderful way to get to know people. April 13th, come from 9 to noon and help us take care of what God has given us, has granted to us. Also, a way of figuring out kind of how God has made us is our spiritual gifts class that's coming up in a couple of weeks. There's information about dates and times on here. We also have a couples group that's kind of restarting. So they're going to meet on a Sunday afternoon, third Sunday of April. So lots going on. There are ways to sign up for our newsletter as well. So we hope you'll do that. But let's spend some time in prayer right now and give God thanks for this amazing day. Let's pray together. You pray with me. We have this meditation bell that helps us remember the prayer space. Let's pray. Almighty God, this is the day that you've made for us to experience hope like never before. So whatever hardship or sorrow we're carrying this morning, help us to hear this good news of an empty tomb and know that your love conquers it all. Lord, for those who grieve this morning, may they know the truth of a stone rolled away that says that death doesn't ever get to win again. We will be with you and our loved ones forever. That stone being removed also means that even before death, we can't be separated from your love and grace ever again. Lord, for those places around the world where violence erupts with shouts, let the shouts of our alleluias overshadow them. Let peace break out instead of war. And let those peacemakers create ways for love and truth to win over hatred and violence. Lord, for this community, may we be able to shout out loud with words or our lives or both that your love is real, that you desire for the whole creation to be reconciled to you through the miracle of this day. Help us to live out that truth forever. And Lord, we especially pray for people within our community today, for Jenny and Tom Olson and the death of their aunts this week, Jean and Joyce. We continue to pray for Elvina Phillips, for all those who surround and love her. We pray for Judy and Dean as they're working with hospice for Dean. And Lord, all those other prayers on our hearts and minds this morning, we know that you hear them, that you lift them into your care. And so we bring these and all our prayers and praise to you, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ, our risen Lord. We pray in his name. Amen. And as we gather around this table, we remember that in the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." And again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Let us pray together our Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. All are welcome to commune here at New Life, including children. So parents, if you wish your child to receive communion, please just let me know or have them hold out their hand. That's totally fine. We do have gluten-free wafers up here as well. If you have that need, let me know. Come, all is ready.
Nothing worth more that could ever come close. Nothing can compare. You're our living home. Your presence, Lord.
I've tasted and seen of the sweetest of loves, when the heart becomes free, and the shame is undone. Your presence, Lord. Holy Spirit, you are. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for, to be overcome by your presence, Lord. Your presence, Lord. There's nothing worth more that will ever come close. Nothing can compare. You're our living hope. Your presence, Lord. I've tasted and seen of the sweetest of loves, when my heart becomes free, yet my shame is undone. Your presence, Lord. Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come love this place and to be overcome by your presence, Lord.
Remember the blessing that comes with this amazing gift of a little piece of bread and a little bit of wine or juice. The body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus the Christ strengthens you and keeps you in his grace. Amen. And now may the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine on you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let's stand and send ourselves out. Let's thrive.
Make darkness run in.
joy unspeakable, faith unsinkable, love unstoppable.
Thanks be to God.